Good morning, student. In last session, we have started our first chapter, that is overview of operating system. In that, we covered the concept of OS, the component of OS, and operation of the OS, view of OS. Now, in short, we will take the review of that points. Operating system, it is a very essential part of any computer system. The operating system is an interface between user of computers and the computer hardware. It is the overview of computer system and the place of operating system. It is the component of operating system. There are four component operating system, that is the computer hardware, operating system, application programs, and users. Operations of operating system. The operations are program management, resource management, and security and protection. Then the views of operating system. There are two views of operating system, that is the user view and system view. These all points are covered in last session. Today we will learn the different types of operating system. Basically, the operating system is divided into two types, that is single user operating system and multi user operating system. Now we will see the detail of single user operating system and multi user operating system. In single user operating system, it is an operating system in which only one user can take the advantage of various features embedded in it. It has limited features to access a single user only. It has to be installed on every individual machine. It does not have advanced feature. It provides limited facilities. The example of single user operating system are the MS-DOS and Windows. The second, multi-user operating system. In multi-user operating system, it is an operating system in which multiple users can take the various advantages of the features embedded in it. It has features designed for multiple users. It takes the advantage of network. Multiple users can be created in such operating system. The data of one user is secured from another user. No user can access the data of other users. In short, it provides the security and protection. The example of multi-user operating systems are Windows XP, Windows 7, all Linux family operating system. There are different types of multi-user operating system. In that, in our syllabus, we learn the different types of operating system. The first is batch operating system. It is a single user operating system. And after that, all the multi-user operating system, that are multi-programming operating system, time-sharing operating system, multiprocessor operating system, distributed operating system, and real-time operating system. Now, these all different types of operating system learn detail one by one. First, we will see the batch operating system. The batch operating system. In early days, punch cards were used to record the user's job, which was manually job done by the human operator. To avoid continuous human operator deotion, the concept of batch processing system was developed. A batch stands for sequence of user job. This type of operating system does not interact with the computer directly. There is an operator which takes similar jobs having same requirement and group them into batches. It is the responsibility of operator to sort the job which similar needs. We will see the detail in figure. This figure shows the batch operating system architecture. There are different users. They submit their job and those all jobs are submitted to operator. Then what is the task of operator? Operator will sort the jobs which have similar requirement and make their batches, and those batches are submitted to operating system to proceed that. It is called as a batch operating system. In this type of operating system, job sequence was decided by an operator. The job were recognized with the special marker which indicating the start and the end of those jobs. In this system, operators batched together jobs with the similar needs and submitted to the batch processing system, and then those were executed automatically without any operator interruption. After execution of job, it was sent to the appropriate user. There are some advantages and disadvantages of batch operating system. Advantages: it is very difficult to guess the time required by any job to complete. Processor of the batch system know how long the job would be when it is in queue. Means what? The batch operating system is basically depend on single user operating system. At the same time, only one user can access the batch operating system. So it is very difficult to guess the time required to execute those jobs. Again, the jobs are not executed one by one. The jobs, those have same requirement or similar requirement, those jobs are together to form a batch. So those batch are executed sequentially. So there is no specified time is depend. So it is very difficult. Second, multiple users can share the batch system. Once the batch is created, those batch are used for the next use also. Next, it is easy to manage large work repeatedly in batch system. Once a batch is created, so that batch is used for again and again for the different tasks, because the batch are created by multiple jobs which having similar requirement. So it is very easy to manage large work. Second, disadvantages of batch operating system: lack of interaction between user and the job. The jobs are not directly submitted to computer system. First, those all jobs are handled by the human intervention. So it is a lack of interaction between user and the job. Second, CPU is often idle because the speed of mechanical I/O devices is lower than the CPU. As earlier we see, the batch operating system, it take the intervention of human, so the jobs are serially executed one by one. So CPU is get often ideal. Third, difficult to provide the desired priority. There are multiple jobs are waiting to execute a program. So it is difficult to provide the priority because the high priority programs are waiting for a long time. If one of the prioritized job getting long time, it may lose their content. So it is difficult to provide the desired priority. These are the some advantages and disadvantages of batch operating system. Next type is multiprogramming operating system. In multi-programming operating system, the process of executing multiple number of programs simultaneously or concurrently is known as multi-programming. Means what? Multi-programming is the ability to execute multiple programs at the same time on single processor machine. One or more program reside in the main memory which are ready to execute. The CPU can execute only one instruction at a time. If the currently executing process perform input-output operations or waiting for input-output, then the operating system may interrupt that process and gives the control to other process residing in a main memory. Because the memory schematic is divided into two parts, that is a user area and system area. In system area, the CPU is placed, and in user area, there are multiple programs are being running. So one program is submitted to CPU, so rest of other programs are completing their resources. The main aim of multiprogramming is to make CPU busy until as there are processes waiting to execute. But single user cannot keep either CPU or the IO devices busy at all time. So multiprogramming is introduced. This is memory layout of multiprogramming. Here, as we see, the memory is divided into two area, that is user area and system area. In system area, that is the operating system, where all the jobs or programs are being executed. And in user area, the users provide the programs. For example, job 2 is getting a CPU to execute the processes. At that time, job 1, job 3 and job 4 are in user area, where they fulfill their resources. It may be IO or other resources. So it is called as a multi-programming. In multi-programming, at the same time, system area is used as well as user area is used. But in single user, it cannot be utilized fully CPU and IO devices, because in single user, only one user can used. So one user input a one job at the same time. So one job is get into the system area for the execution. Next program is not executed because the user area is empty. So multiprogramming is introduced to keep the CPU and IO devices keep busy. Some advantages and disadvantages of multiprogramming operating system. That is, first advantage, high and efficient CPU utilization. As earlier we see, the CPU utilization is very important. Second, user feel that many programs are allocated CPU almost simultaneously. Disadvantages, CPU scheduling is required, because in multiprogramming, more than two programs are being executed. So it is very important to keep their schedule to execute one by one jobs. Second, to accommodate many jobs in memory. Memory management is required. In memory, there are more programs are in queue. So it is very important to manage that memory, because the main memory has limited space. So it is required to manage the memory to keep the processes or programs temporarily. Next, this is multitasking operating system. In multitasking operating system, multitasking is the logical extension of multiprogramming. The ability of an operating system to perform more than one task simultaneously at the same time is called as multitasking. In multiprogramming, the operating system to perform more than one program simultaneously at the same time. Here in multitasking, operating system to perform more than one task. It is the difference between multiprogramming and multitasking. A task is a particular operation like edit, copy, paste, delete, open, close. A user to perform more than one computer task at a time. To perform multiple tasks simultaneously, the operating system execute one job in the foreground and many jobs in background. Foreground jobs are the jobs which have user interaction, and background jobs are those jobs which do not require user intervention. For example, printing a file of 100 pages, sorting a database file containing 1000 records. The maximum number of jobs that can be executed in the background are 20. But if the system is very powerful, then maximum of 50 jobs can be executed in the background. At window-based system, multitasking do allow user to perform multiple tasks simultaneously, thus the saving the system time. Another example of multitasking is while editing one file, we can simultaneously print another file. Here, editing is a foreground job while printing is a background job. These are some examples of multitasking operating here. In this figure, we saw operating system handle the Word file, opening email and another web browser at the same time. These are the multiple tasks performed by the operating system. That is called as a multitasking operating system. Next. Some advantages and disadvantages of multitasking operating system. Advantages. High and efficient CPU utilization. As earlier we see, the multitasking, it is a logical extension of multi-programming. So, it is also utilized fully CPU. User feel that many programs are allocated CPU almost simultaneously. Disadvantages, CPU scheduling is required. We know more than two programs are being executed simultaneously, so it is very necessary to schedule their task. Second, to accommodate many jobs in memory, because each and every jobs are executed in CPU, so it requires some memory. So memory management is very required. Next, the difference between multiprogramming and multitasking. In multiprogramming, multiple processes are run concurrently at the same time on a single processor. In multitasking, multitasking is when more than one task is executed at a single time by utilizing multiple CPUs. It is based on the concept of context switch. It is based on concept of time sharing. Multiple programs reside in the main memory simultaneously to improve CPU utilization so that CPU does not sit idle for a long time. It enables execution of multiple tasks and processes at the same time to increase CPU performance. It utilizes single CPU for execution of processes. It utilizes multiple CPUs for task allocation. It takes more time to execute the processes. It takes less time. The idea is to reduce the CPU idle time for as long as possible. The idea to allow multiple processes to run simultaneously via time sharing. This is the difference between multiprogramming and multitasking. Next type, that is the time shared operating system. In time sharing operating system, Time sharing is a logical extension of multi-programming. Time sharing system allow many users to share computer simultaneously. Time sharing is a technique which enable many people located at various terminals to use a particular computer system at the same time. Multi-sharing or multitasking is a logical extension of multi-programming. In short, in time sharing system, there is a large central computer to which a number of terminals are connected to each other. The large central computer provides a time slice, regular interval to each terminal. This is shown in this figure. There is a large computer system which connected multiple terminals. This CPU or computer system, it provides the time to each and every terminal as a time slice. Means what? For example, computer system, it provides the time that is 15 minutes. So that 15 minutes are used for these six terminals. Means what? The 15 divided by 6, that is called as a time slice. Means what? Each and every terminals used a 1 point something time for the execution. That is called as a time shared operating system. The main principle used by time sharing system were CPU scheduling and programming to provide each user with a small portion of total time shared. In time sharing system, the time is managed properly for multiple users in an interactive manner and at a responsible cost. Time sharing allows many users to share computers simultaneously. The switching time between the terminal is very fast and users have the impression that they are working on their own computer. A time sharing system is basically a multi-programming, multitasking and multi-user environment of large computer system. In short, in time sharing system, there is a large computer system to which the number of terminals are connected as shown in figure. At each terminal, a user can perform any of the operation. The large central computer provides a time slice at a regular interval to each terminal. The time slice may be of particular microsecond or millisecond. The time slice is switched so rapidly that every user of the terminal feels that the whole computer is dedicated to himself or herself. CPU does not wait for any operation of every job. It immediately switched to another job as the time slice is very short. One of the first time sharing operating system developed was the compatible time sharing system developed at MIT Institute. These are some advantages and disadvantages of time sharing operating system. Advantages: provide the advantage of quick response because the total time is divided into number of time slices and each time slice is allocated to each and every terminal. So it gives the quick response to execute the task. Second, avoids duplication of software because there is only one central large computer system. So all the softwares are reside on that central large computer system. So it avoids the duplication. Reduce CPU idle time because there is only one large computer system to which number of terminals are connected. So one by one, all the terminals are submitted their jobs for the execution. So it reduces the CPU time idle. Disadvantages: problems of reliability. Means if the central latch computer system gets failed, the entire system will get failed. So it is a problem of reliability. Second, question of security and integrity of user program and data. It does not provide the more security because there is only one large computer system and which is a central. So all the terminals are connected to only that central system. So it does not provide the security. Last, the problem of data communication. Data communication means the exchange of information between users. So it is very complicated to exchange the data because of quick response, because of limited time quantum. These are the some advantages and disadvantages of time sharing operating system. Next, multiprocessor operating system. In multiprocessor operating system, multiprocessing is the use of two or more central processing unit within a single computer system. We share the system bus, clock, memory and other resources. The multiprocessors are increasing in importance nowadays. These systems have multiple processors working in parallel that share the computer, clock, memory, bus and peripheral devices. This system is also called as parallel system or tightly coupled system. The main advantage of multiprocessor system to get maximum work in shorter period. In previous type, we learned the time sharing operating system. In that, there is a central large computer system, that is a processor. In multiprocessor, there are more than two processors are used, which is showed in this figure. There are multiple CPUs are connected to share the memory, clock and some peripheral devices. These all CPUs are having one memory because they share the memory, clock and peripheral devices. These systems are also called as tightly coupled system. Tightly coupled system means what? They require large resources. Multiprocessing sometimes refers to execution of multiple concurrent software processes in a system. The main advantage of multiprocessing is to get maximum work done in shorter period. The same copy of data into main memory can be shared by multiple processor for processing them instead of making its copy, because these all CPUs are share only one memory. Once data is copied on memory, that all the data are used by the each and every CPU. The system provides reliability that if one processor get failed, the system does not fail. In previous time sharing operating system, we saw if the central large computer system get failed, entire system will get failed. But in multiprocessor operating system, if one CPU or one processor get failed, it does not affect on other. One CPU can run a particular task and other can work as the backup of CPU. Next, the multiprocessor operating system has two types, that is symmetric multiprocessor and asymmetric multiprocessor. Now one by one we see the types of multiprocessor operating system. The first, asymmetric multiprocessor system. Asymmetric multiprocessing, also called as master-slave architecture. In asymmetric system, each processor is given a predefined task. There is a master processor that gives the instruction to all the other processors. Asymmetric multiprocessor system contain a master-slave relationship. In figure, the one system is a master and others are slaves. One processor known as master processing having overall control on the system. It allocates work to all the slave processor. This is figured out in this image. It is a master and all other are slaves. All control of this system is on this master. This master provides the task to each and every its slave. So it is called as the master-slave architecture. Second, symmetric multiprocessor. In symmetric multiprocessor, two or more processor connected via high bandwidth link and managed by one operating system. Each processor run as individual copy of operating system, and then copies communicate with one another as needed. Each processor has equal access to I/O devices. Means there is no master-slave relationship between the processor. In this type of system, each process contains a similar copy of operating system and they all communicate with each other. All the processors are not in master-slave relationship. It treats as a individual processor. Each processor individually work and hand over to each user to access all the data. There are some advantages and disadvantages of multiprocessor operating system. Now, one by one, see all the advantages and disadvantages of multiprocessor operating system. First, more reliable system. Means what? In a multiprocessor system, even if one processor fails, the system will not be failed. This ability to continue working hardware failure is known as graceful degradation. For example, if there are five processors in a multiprocessor system and one of them fail, then remaining four processors are still working. So the system only becomes slower and does not ground to the fail. That is, increase the reliable. Second, enhanced throughput. If multiple processors are working in continuously, then the throughput of the system increases. That is, number of processes getting executed per unit of time increase. If there are n processor, then the throughput increased by an amount just under n. Next, more economic system. Means what? Multiprocessor system are cheaper than single processor system in the long run because they share the data usage, data storage, peripheral devices, power supplies. If there are multiple processes that share the data, it is better to schedule them on multiprocessor system with shared data than different computer system with multiple copies of the data. There are some disadvantages. The first, increased expense. Even though multiprocessor systems are cheaper in long run than using multiple computer systems, still they are quite expensive because it is much cheaper to buy a single simple processor system than a multiprocessor system. If this system is used for the large business because they are required the large throughput, at that time multiprocessor operating system is used. But for the short business, there is not need to multiple processor used. At that time the cost is very increased, so it is on disadvantages. Second, complicated operating system required. There are multiple processor in multiprocessor system that share peripheral devices, memory. So it is much more complicated to schedule processes and impart resources to processes than in single processor system. Hence, a more complex and complicated operating system is required in multiprocessor system. Last, the large main memory required. Because in figure, we see the multiple processes are connected through the shared memory, clock and peripheral device. All the processors are use only one memory. So it required large main memory. All the processor in the multiprocessor system share the memory. So much larger pool of memory is required as compared to single processor system. These are some advantages and disadvantages of multiprocessor operating system. The next, the real-time operating system. The real-time operating system A real-time operating system is a computer system that requires not only that computed result to be correct, but also that result be produced within a specified time period. Result produced after time period, even if correct, may not real value. Means what? The real-time system is subjected to real-time. That is, response should be guaranteed within a specified time or system should meet a specified deadline. If output is produced after deadline and that result may be correct, that is not called as a real-time. Means what? The output should be correct and within a time, that is called as a real-time operating system. The example of real-time operating systems are flight control system, real-time monitors, satellite communication. These are the real-time operating system. There are two types of real-time operating system, that is hard real-time operating system and soft real-time operating system. First, hard real-time operating system. This type of system can never miss its deadline. Means the programs and tasks are strictly executed in any critical situation and that must be within a time. A real-time system which guaranteeing that critical tasks may be completed within their time period is called as hard real-time system. Critical system are hard real-time system. In hard real-time system, tardiness is decreases. Tardiness means how late a real-time system complete its task with respect to its deadline. The example of hard real-time is flight control system. Second, soft real-time system. This type of system can miss its deadline. Means what? In soft real-time system, a critical real-time task will get priority over other task and it will having that priority unit it's complete their task. The usefulness of result produced by the soft real-time system decreases gradually with increasing tardiness. The example of soft real-time is telephone switches, network devices like router, microwaves, oven. I will explain one example of real-time operating system, that is satellite communication. Consider the example of satellite which is sending data to a ground station at the speed of 1000 samples per second. Satellite communication required two bandwidth, that is uplink and downlink. Uplink, data sent from ground station to satellite, and again the downlink is used for the data coming from satellite to ground station, because to communicate devices or users are on ground station. So the satellite requires two bandwidth, that is the uplink and downlink. The system which is available at the ground station has to respond in 1 millisecond to create file, store one sample and save the file in the next successive millisecond, perform the same operation till the 1000 samples have been saved. If the system at the ground station fails to respond in every millisecond, then the data will be lost or the application will fail. It means 1 millisecond is the worst case response time for the system. Worst case response time is the largest time for which the system is still working properly. Means what? The uplink sends the data in 1 millisecond. Within that second, the downlink also receives that data. That is called as a real-time operating system. If the downlink is not provide the data within 1 millisecond, that is not a real-time operating system. Next, there are some real-time operating systems are, as discussed, satellite communication, simulations, industrial controls, military applications, flight control system, temperature control in industry, sensor-based traffic light control system. These are the some real-time operating systems. Next, the difference between time sharing and real-time operating system. In time sharing operating system, it providing a quick response to the request. In real-time operating system, it focus on accomplishing a computational task before its specified a deadline. Time sharing operating system shared between the user. In real-time operating system, no sharing take place and events are external to the system. In time sharing operating system, more than one application executed simultaneously. Because in time sharing operating system, there is a large central operating system which connected multiple terminals. So those execute multiple applications or multiple programs simultaneously. But in real time operating system, single application at a time. In time sharing operating system, the programs can be modified and written by the user. But in real time operating system, once the program is being executed, execution is started, no modification is possible. Response time of time sharing operating system is generated within a second, but there is no compulsion. In real time operating system, the user must get the response within a defined time period. If the response is generated correct after deadline, which is not called as a real time system. So here time constraint is very important. Time sharing operating system takes place among the processes. In real time operating system, processes does not present. These are some difference between time sharing operating system and real time operating system. The next, distributed operating system. In distributed operating system, a number of computers have been connected to one another by links enabling electronic data transfer and sharing of data among various computers. Means what? Various autonomous interconnected computers communicate with each other using a shared communication network. Instead of central computer system with centralized application data we have a number of computers with distributed application data. This is the architecture of distributed operating system. Here, the network through which the multiple computers are interconnected to each other. In that, each system independent possesses their own memory unit and CPU. Means what? Each and every machine, it has own memory and own CPU. Next, the remote access is enabled within the device connected in the network. Means the major benefit of working with this type of operating system is that it is always possible that one user can access the files or softwares which are not actually present on his or her system, but on same other system connected within this network, that is called as a remote access. There are some advantages and disadvantages of distributed operating system. Advantages: failure of one will not affect the other network communication, as all systems are independent from each other. In distributed operating system, the multiple computers are interconnected to each other. In that, one of the computer system get fails, it does not affect on other network. Second, electronic mail increase the data exchange speed. In distributed operating system, we use the network, means what? The computer systems are interconnected to each other. So we can transfer or exchange the data very fast. Third, resources are being shared. Computation is highly fast and durable. There are multiple computer systems are interconnected, so those computer systems are user resources in sharing. So next, load on host computer reduced, because in distributed operating system there is no any central computer system to handle all the load of other computers. Each and every computer system as work as a individual, so it reduces the load of host computer. Next, these systems are easily scalable, as many systems can be easily added in the network. For example, first we create a network of 10 computers. If we want to add two more computers in that network, so it is very easy to add the computers in the network. It is not, does not affect on other devices which are connected in that networks. The disadvantage of distributed system: failure of main network will stop the entire communication. Once the entire network will get fail, then the entire communication is failure. Next, to establish distributed system, the language which are used are not well defined yet. Means what? In distributed operating system, there are multiple computer systems are connected. They have a different languages, so the communication is not well, because each and every system used the various applications. Last, these type of system are not readily available, as they are very expensive. Not only that, the underlying software is highly complex and not understood well yet. This advantage is overcome in centralized system. In centralized system, all the softwares which are very expensive, they are bought once and keep the copy on central machine. Then that central copy is accessed by other system which are connected that central machine. But in distributed operating system, each and every computer system is treated as the individually. So it is very expensive to install those expensive softwares and application to individual machine. So this type of system is not readily available, as they are very expensive. थैंक यू।